a presentation of AIT.
Can't you go any faster? We're 3 seconds behind their best time. You're never gonna beat them if you drive like that.
I can't go any faster.
We've gotta make that turn a lot faster. If we lose to the afterburners, we're gonna be the laughing stock of the neighborhood.
Well, it wasn't my idea to challenge them in a race.
Well, they insulted old number seven. I had to do it.
The afterburners have never lost a race. They're unstoppable.
We'll see about that.
You better slow down.
Hey, I know what I'm doing.
Oh. Why didn't you slow down? Now we'll never beat the afterburners. I told you to slow down.
Okay, I heard you. Now what are we gonna do? The race is in 3 days.
Well, we better get this car fixed, and fast. Hey, Rollo.
Hey, Rollo, what's up?
Hey, guys. Oh, a hole in the ozone bigger than Texas. How's old number seven running?
Not so well.
Ouch.
Do you think you can fix it?
I just finished fixing your skateboard.
Yeah, he has a little trouble with wheels.
So what happened this time?
Well, Mario Andretti here challenged some kids in the other neighborhood to a race.
The afterburners.
They've never lost a race.
Well, they called old number seven a weenie car. My honor was at stake.
Yeah, well, I've seen them on the track, and they can go at least 3 seconds faster than our best time.
Maybe you do have a weenie car.
No way. We can beat them. There's just this one turn. Dead man's curve always makes our cars skid out.
Let me see. Huh. Well, I think I can fix the car. And maybe between you and me and old Mr. Newton, we can take the sting out of dead man's curve.
Mr. Who?
So this means you're gonna help us.
I always help when honor's at stake. But look, I've got some things I have to do around the lab. I can meet you guys at the track later this afternoon.
Rollo, you're a lifesaver.
See you later.
All right, see you there.
See ya.
Hey, guys.
Rollo.
So this is Dead Man's Curve. Doesn't look so menacing.
It is.
Well, what do you need to know to go faster through the turn?
Well, we'd have to know the fastest we could go and not skid off the track.
Well, how can we do that?
Huh? We could use these.
What are those going to do?
Well, let's see. Send the car around the track, and we'll see what happens.
Okay.
Oh, cool. That tells us the speed of the car.
I get it. With these probes, we can tell the fastest we can go and still make the turn.
All right. Hey, let's get started.
Okay.
Thank you. Well, at any speed over 25 miles per hour, the car skids out.
Yeah, I've seen the afterburners race, and we can't win if we slow down that much during the turn.
Well, we'll have to find a way to go faster.
Well, how are we gonna do that? We've tried everything.
Everything?
Well, okay, not everything.
I didn't think so. Now let's get down to solving this problem. Why does the car skid?
Well, it goes too fast.
Yeah, the wheels don't grab well enough. What are you doing?
Solving your problem.
That's not going to solve our problem.
We'll see about that. What'll happen to the car with this water in the turn?
It'll never make the turn.
Yeah, it's going to slide.
Well, Roz, send the car around the track, and we'll see what happens.
I told you it would slide. We can do that without you.
Yeah, but which direction did it slide?
It slid straight out.
Why?
Because that's where it was headed.
Well, I mean, why did it slide?
Well, the tires couldn't grab the track because someone put water on the turn, so it slid straight out.
Well, why did it slide straight out?
We've been through this, haven't we?
Yeah. Let's pack up and go back to the lab. I think I have some things there that might help clear this up. All right, now, I wanted to show you guys something.
Everybody continues in a state of rest or uniform motion in a straight line, unless it is compelled to change that state by forces impressed upon it. Sir Isaac Newton. Sir Isaac Newton? Is that the Mr. Newton you were talking about?
Yeah.
Oh, he's the guy they named the fig Newtons after.
No, he's the guy that got hit in the head with the apple and shouted, Eureka.
No, that was William Tell.
No, William Tell was the Lone Ranger.
Oh, wait a minute. He was not the Lone Ranger. You guys are confusing me. Newton was the guy who supposedly was hit on the head with an apple. But it was another person entirely who shouted Eureka, and that was in the bathtub.
Well, what does the Lone Ranger have to do with this?
Absolutely nothing. Can we get on with this? Where were we?
We were talking about Newton.
So, is this Newton guy the reason our car won't turn?
No, he's dead. But the laws he observed are affecting your car.
Well, what does that mean?
It means that once our car starts to move, it tends to keep going in a straight line.
Yeah, but what does Newton mean in the first part of his law when he talks about things being in a state of rest or motion?
Well, let's take a look.
Cool.
That's horrible. Why do we have to watch car wrecks?
Well, this tells us a little bit about motion. Can you explain what you're seeing?
Well, the cars crash and the dummies fly into the windshield.
Yes.
You got it.
I think the dummies got it.
Well, better them than us.
Well, why did the dummies fly into the windshield?
It's like what your Newton dude said. See, the dummies continue moving forward until they're stopped.
Because objects in motion tend to stay in motion.
What can we do so that the dummy in the back seat doesn't fly forward?
Oh, put a seatbelt on him.
How do seatbelts work?
You buckle.
I had to ask. Why do you buckle him?
Well, the seatbelt pushes against the dummy and keeps him in his seat.
The seatbelt helps overcome the dummy's tendency to continue moving forward.
I hate watching this. These cars hit so hard.
They're only traveling at 35 miles per hour.
35 miles per hour really doesn't seem that fast, but it tears up those cars.
And the dummies.
Well, that's why seatbelts are so important. The life you save could be your own.
You know, sometimes when you're riding in a car, it doesn't even feel like you're moving. Why is that?
Well, that brings up an interesting point. What if you were riding in the car, and there was another car directly beside you traveling at the same speed?
Is this one of those math word problems?
No. How fast would the other car appear to be traveling?
Sounds like a math problem.
Well, it would look like it was standing still.
Why?
Because we'd be moving in the same way the other car is moving.
Do you mean that the appearance of motion depends on how you're viewing it?
Yeah.
What?
Come on.
feel stupid.
You can't be a slave to fashion and scientific discovery at the same time. Are you ready?
I guess.
All right, I'll tell you when to throw the ball.
I hope no one recognizes me.
Relax!
Racer, start your engine!
Hello. Can we hurry up, please?
All right. Go! Throw the ball!
You were great.
Now, what was that supposed to do?
What did you see?
Nothing. I threw the ball up and I caught it.
How did it travel?
It went straight up and came straight down.
What did you see?
The ball didn't go straight up and straight down.
It did too?
It did not. You threw the ball up in the middle of one parking space and caught it in the middle of the next one.
I did?
You did.
Well, why did the two of you see things so differently?
Because I was moving and Roz was standing still when she watched me.
Exactly.
So there was a purpose to all this.
There always is. Let's go back to the lab and look at the computer.
Hey, that's me.
How'd you do that?
Well, some things are better left unexplained. Watch.
See, the ball did go in a straight line.
That's not a straight line.
Okay, so you were right. The motion is different depending on how you look at it.
Is that always true?
Well, let's look at this motion from a different perspective.
What am I doing on a map?
You're giving us a different perspective. Now, how would Frankie travel if he wanted to roll from his location, somewhere in Minnesota, directly south to the southern tip of Texas?
I could never do that. My legs would fall off.
Work with me, Frankie. We're imagining.
Well, he travels south in a straight line.
Well, if I had jets on my skateboard, I could do it.
Now you're getting into the spirit of things. Are you sure it'd be a straight line?
Well, it all depends on how you looked at it.
And if the wind was at my back, Yeah, well, I'd be deep in the heart of Texas in no time.
Well, how would he look if we were looking at him from a spaceship hovering above the Earth?
Look, if I'm me, I can't see me.
Imagine Roz and I are in the spaceship looking at you on your skateboard in Minnesota as you begin to travel south. How would you look?
Small.
Frankie.
Okay, well, the spaceship wouldn't be moving, so I would appear to move in a straight line. Well, why didn't I move in a straight line?
Because the Earth is spinning.
Yeah, but the spaceship isn't.
Yeah, but when you figure in the motion of the Earth, you didn't travel in a straight line.
Weird.
Yeah, so how Frankie moves depends on how the Earth moves.
Right. The apparent motion depends on your frame of reference.
Okay, so you're suggesting that if we want to beat the afterburners, we have to have them look at the race from a spaceship.
No. It'll take a lot more than a spaceship to beat the afterburners.
Well, how are we going to beat them?
Do you have any suggestions?
Well, we already know we have to keep the car from going straight in Dead Man's Curve.
Yeah, but how do we do that?
If we could only get the tires to stick better to the track.
That could work. Can you think of some other ways to keep the car from going straight?
Well, what if we bank the curve?
What do you mean?
Oh, yeah, we'll bank it like in a real race track.
What would banking the curve do?
Well, see, the bank forces the car to turn.
How does it force the car to turn?
It pushes against the car.
Could you say it overcomes the car's tendency to continue moving straight?
Yeah. Hey, it works like the seatbelt.
Huh?
The bank curve pushes against the car like the seatbelt and keeps the car from going straight.
That's right. The seatbelt overcomes the dummy's tendency to continue moving forward in the same way that the bank curve overcomes the car's tendency to keep going straight.
Well, where are we going to find a bank curve?
That's easy. I've got a friend named Remote Control Randy. He's got a track in his backyard. I'm sure he'll let us use it. Come on.
Hey, Motorola, you were right. The car can go a lot faster through the bank curve.
Because the bank curve helps overcome the car's tendency to keep going straight.
I knew some of this was sinking in.
With this bank curve, we're going to crush the afterburners.
Wait a minute. We'll be racing on the same track. They'll have the bank curve, too.
They will?
They will.
Oh, they will. Well, now what are we going to do?
Well, we'll just have to find some other ways to go faster.
Like what?
Well, what if we tried some of the other cars Randy gave us?
An abandoned old number 7? Uh-uh, never.
Well, she's got a point. Randy's cars can tell us what types of cars corner better than others. Maybe we can make some changes to old number 7.
Come on, let's try them. You want to beat the afterburners, don't you?
Each one handles a little bit differently.
Yeah, and they all corner pretty well.
Well, what's different about them?
Well, the truck has bigger tires, so it really grabs the track, but it's so high it flips over a lot.
Yeah, and this one's wider and lower to the ground.
Yeah, but it goes around those corners really fast. Do you think you can make these changes to old number 7 so we could beat the afterburners?
No. Well, we'd have to give it better tires, make it wider, and lower to the ground.
Let's give it a try. I think I have some stuff at the lab that just might do the trick.
Too bad we can't use that bank curve. That car was really moving.
Well, what if we make the bank curve steeper?
What do you mean?
Well, would a steeper curve make the car go faster?
How steep could you make it?
Good question.
That's old number 7.
What would happen if we made the bank so steep that it was straight up and down?
Well, the car would either fall down or fly off.
Well, not if we went fast enough.
Why?
It's going faster. Is that what's keeping it up?
Well, why doesn't it fly off?
Well, let's leave that for another day. We've got a race to win.
Be gentle.
Wrench.
Here are some questions for further discussion. Why did old number 7 spin out at Dead Man's Curve? What are some ways to make it go faster through the turn? And how could you test this? Why did banking the curve allow the car to go faster without spinning out? Enjoy your journey around the fast track of motion. Remember to keep your eyes on the road and your minds on science.
Copy of the Minds on Science Teacher's Guide, contact your ITV service agency or send 750 check or money order to AIT Department Minds on Science, Bloomington, Indiana 47402-0120.